A Florida man is currently behind bars, awaiting trial for his involvement in the January 6th Capitol insurrection. And he is behind bars because the man was dumb enough to brag about being at that insurrection and post pictures and videos of himself at the insurrection on Facebook. Here's what happened. A couple days after the riots took place at the Capitol, Florida man by the name of John Nassif was in a Facebook argument with somebody who said, oh, they're pushing down the cops to get in the door. So Nassif responds, he's like, you know I was there, right? And starts to talk about how the cops let us in. He posts video of it, basically bragging like, nope, you're so wrong. Look, I've got the video evidence. And so, of course, the Department of Justice got their hands on this and said, huh, I guess we need to go arrest Mr. Nassif for being a part of this. And they did. Now, Mr. Nassif is not the first Republican, or Trump supporter, I should say, really, who got arrested because they posted stupid stuff on social media about attending the Capitol riot. And honestly, he's probably not going to be the last either. This is what happens when very stupid people commit crimes. They leave evidence, but in this case, it's not even about leaving evidence. It's about like bragging about the evidence. Like, aha, look what I have. I'm here. Like, it's like if you were robbing a bank, then afterwards you posted the video on Facebook and say, hey, I made money the easy way. What's wrong with the rest of you? Then you get arrested and you're like, but why? I was giving out financial tips to people. No. You broke the law, and now you're in jail for it. Now, Mr. Nassif did have a Zoom hearing this week. I am so sorry. It's not funny because these people really did something horrible that's going to be talked about in history books for decades to come. But he had a Zoom hearing, and he's terrified about the fact that one, he couldn't afford legal representation, so we had to get a public defender. But two, he's afraid because that public defender is from D.C., because that's the jurisdiction where all this happened. That's what happens, dude. And he doesn't think he can get a fair shake with a public defender from D.C., because obviously, if you're from D.C., you're probably part of the swamp, right? But nevertheless, the judge did try to reassure him, like, listen, this guy's already done a lot of these cases. So he's pretty well versed in it. He knows what he's doing. He has an obligation to represent you to the best of his ability. So there you go, Mr. Nassif. Hope that puts your fears at ease. But you're a 55-year-old man. You could be spending some of the few best years of your life now behind bars. You know, you're getting up there in age. You really don't have a lot of good years left before you start experiencing health problems. Before your age catches up with you, you just can't physically do what you used to do. And you're going to spend those years in jail. One, because you were stupid enough to brag about this stuff on social media. But two, because you followed the false prophet of Donald Trump, did his bidding, and then he didn't show up to protect you. It's a shame, really. But you get what you deserve when you screw around like this. And you leave evidence everywhere, you're gonna have to pay the price. This is Hattie. Hattie wants to know why you have not subscribed to our channel. You obviously like our videos, so do us a favor and subscribe.